put your headphones on.
Oh yeah, I've got to give the illusion that I've got
you
proper
actually got
audio
things that
equipment.
work.
Now I can't hear you again.
Okay.
I can hear me! Everyone, welcome to the second episode of this Tough Talks, Tough Topics, Tough Topics.
Yeah, Tough Topics.
Everyone, welcome to the second episode of Tough Topics. I'm Giz and this is...
The woman.
The woman! She said it! That's good. Today we're going to be talking about God and our opinion of God.
Yeah.
Basically, Tough Topics is a video series in which we can have a conversation with each other, in which other people might think that it's a bit weird to have that same conversation. Last week we talked about...
We talked about justified murder.
Justified murder. Today we're going to be talking about God. And before we get ahead and with it, I'd just like to say a big thank you to everyone on Patreon, patreon.com/GizEdwards, who have donated. For a single dollar a month, they're able to get access to this audio file for this video 6 days before it's released on YouTube. That means if you're listening to this on Patreon, it's only been a day since the last one. Great, great time we live in. So if you want to be part of the exclusive Gizzards group, then head over to patreon.com/GizEdwards. I just made the whole table shake with my with my chair. Yeah. Whoop-bush! Carry that. Cool. So my hair is very messy today.
Mine
God.
Is too.
What?
Mine's grim, my hair.
Yeah. God. We're gonna talk about the big G himself. I know, I heard. Everyone else did. What's your opinion on God?
I think that God is a... If there is a dog... A dog?
A dog.
A dog. That's it. God's a dog. If there is a God, that he's deity. Did you hear my little croak?
I didn't.
Oh, my voice went... I think that God's a deity, if he is something up there. But it is the sort of... It's the Watch Theorem. You heard of the Watch Theorem?
I have not heard of the Watch Theorem.
It's a... But it's a sort of an idea that... When you have a watch is made up of so many different compartments and some of the things that are so intrinsic of making, right?
Yeah.
So I think, I don't know if it like follows the idea there is a God or there isn't one, but because there's so many different compartments that work together so well,
yeah,
that it cannot be made by, that's it, it is supporting a God thing because it said that science, because lots of watches are made by hand, right?
All right.
This convoluted thing. And because a watch is so difficult to make,
yeah,
so they're all made by hand normally because you need like a human, like a brain to be able to figure it out and see different parts work together. And that's the idea that there is a God, that science couldn't have made this thing that's so compatible. It'd have to be something out there making it.
A watchmaker.
I don't think it's just a watchmaker. I think it might be a actual being. Most convoluted.
That was incredible. Yeah. Let me just...
You could edit that. I can do it again.
No, I can do this again.
Okay.
You're saying that because a watch is so difficult to make,
yeah,
and every point of a watch has its own purpose,
yeah,
it's impossible to think that there isn't a maker.
Yes, that's correct. That is... Actually, that's it summed up.
Yeah. Cool. Right. So, what's your opinion on it?
Oh, I think that there is a creature or a sort of deity. Don't laugh.
It's a creature.
I think there is something up there, but more of a deity, less than a god.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I am very unsure.
Mm-hmm.
I used to be atheist. And then I was someone who used to believe that we all exist as part of the collective consciousness,
right,
and that we all are God.
I've never heard that idea.
So basically it's a saying so that, let's say we have a unified consciousness and that everything that exists is a droplet from an ocean of constant consciousness, if you know what I mean. So
yeah,
the whole universe is an ocean of consciousness and each individual person is a droplet within that ocean.
Okay.
But it's impossible to tell where the droplet of water begins and the ocean starts or ends.
Okay.
So it, even though everyone is their own unique individual consciousness, that it doesn't matter because it all exists in the same ocean.
Interesting.
I used to believe in that. I used to think we're all God, and then I found out that the very foundations of Satanism has the same principle.
Really?
Yeah, and I thought, maybe not.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, then I was into, like, duality. Like, if there's good, then there must be bad. And now I'm straight up agnostic.
Mm-hmm.
So I have no idea.
Yeah. I think agnostic is the place to be. I do. I think it is, because if you are such a firm believer in something and it's not right, then you spent your whole life believing something that's not right.
Mm-hmm.
But then if it's you're an atheist and you turn out there is something, then you spend your whole life, like, in shadows.
What if heaven exists, but you can only get there if you're an atheist?
But then, at least as a agnostic, then there is some sort of doubt in your mind. Mm. So maybe that's enough to sort of get through pearly gates.
Yeah. Well, I kind of think of it as, like, there's no point in me trying to guess where, or try and understand the concept of God,
mm-hmm.
because it's so far beyond me.
Yeah.
That how could I possibly even begin?
Yeah.
To understand. So I'm very comfortable in my agnosticism, because it's like, well, I don't know, but I don't pretend I do.
Mm.
And I, even though people have faith in God, I just don't.
Yeah. I think that that's a good place to be, because I don't think that if there is a God, there's something that we cannot fathom it.
Mm.
Like, I think people think too hard into it and they get tied up in different theories and different religious ideas of it, and you get lost in it.
Mm.
I think there's no way for our human minds to even comprehend if there is something out there, what is. So you either drive yourself mad by thinking about it, or just let it be a thing that you know you can't comprehend.
Yeah. If there were a God, what is your what's your mental visualization of it?
See, I think he's more like a deity. But when I think of deities, I think of Dioga and Lucia, because they're deities.
Yeah.
I think of things that are like, he's temporal, sort of a being. He hasn't really got a fixed image.
Mm-hmm.
Like maybe some clouds or something. Not clouds, but like a blob.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think he's just so powerful, but he has no control over what happens. He's created this earth.
Yeah.
It might not be even he.
It's, I was just about to say,
yeah,
you mentioned he quite a few times.
Yeah, I think it's because of the whole raised up in...
What have you done?
I think it's a whole raised up in sort of Christian families and stuff.
Mm.
You get to just call him he, because it's, you just call, it's signing, you're assigning him a gender, which I'm going to do because I don't care. But I think if there is a God that we can't comprehend what he looks like, and that thing has no control over the world it's created, and it doesn't really want to give control, I think he just like leaves it. All right.
I vision God as Family Guy's God.
I don't know what Family Guy's God looks like.
Just what you'd think God looks like.
Oh.
Beard, bald head,
oh.
White, like, cloak
thing.
But
like how they do the God in Simpsons, they never reveal his face.
Yeah.
But he's got five fingers.
Yeah, the only character who's got five fingers is God. Yeah, if God were to exist, I would see him, in my head, he's cartoon God.
Yeah.
And I'd hope he would be. Like, if God ever did just go, hey, I'm God, I'd hope that he would be like cartoon God.
I think it's a bit like, you know, the angels and Supernatural, how they have to have human vessels.
Yeah.
I think God's a bit like that, that if you comprehend his true form, you couldn't.
You just couldn't.
You just couldn't, yeah. Yeah.
No, I'd agree with that.
Are we doing this on like religion, or are we doing this just on God?
What's your point with religion then?
I don't like organized religions at all.
Okay, let's go with that.
Because they're just brainwashing people.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
So you come from a very Catholic family,
mm-hmm.
and I come from a very atheist style.
Yeah.
But I went to a church school.
Yeah.
As my first school.
I didn't go to any. It's weird though, because I come from a Catholic family, Irish Catholic, but I wasn't raised a Catholic.
Mm.
But I know what part, I know what bit. That sort of changed my mind about organized religions. I know when it was, and it was when I was going through a bit of a funk at university, and I needed something. So I thought, you know what, my friend who I lived with, she was a very devout Christian and very devout Baptist. So she said to me, come to church. She's always saying to me, come to church every Sunday. I thought, you know what? I'll try it. I'll just see what it's like, because I've never been to a ceremony. I've never been to Sunday, you know, church service. Did go, and I hated it. I was A, really bored, and also they had, because I think Baptist churches are very like brimstone and fire, you know. And this kid was being christened or something. I don't know. He's had his head dunked in some water.
Drowned.
And he was like screaming about how much he loved Jesus and stuff, and he was.
When you say screaming,
he was properly like yelling, like properly like, damn, you know, and everybody was clapping along, and it was mental to watch. And I felt like I was the only person there thinking, this is weird. He's seven.
Yeah.
You know, he shouldn't have this such stupid devotion. And the only thing I liked about it was the fact they gave us biscuits afterwards.
That is a positive. That's how they,
that's how they draw me in. Yeah.
I went to a church school, and I've done mass and ceremony many times.
Yeah.
And growing up, it was just the norm. Looking back at it now, it's like, why did I partake in that?
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't make any sense.
I do think I don't believe in it personally, but I do think it can help a lot of people.
Oh yeah, 100%. But the thing that it will help people with is the stuff like community.
Yeah.
And you don't really need an organized religion or a god per se to do that.
Gives people sort of opportunity though, if they need something like that, they can.
Yeah, I suppose.
Like when I went to the Vatican, my mum's a Catholic. It was kind of meant. It was. I really did feel very emotional around there, because when you go into that building, into St. Peter's, you do get like hit by a wall of like obsessional love, because people are in there prostrating themselves on the floor, and you've got loads of nuns and stuff, and they're worshipping, and you do feel really emotional when you go in there by the amount of love that's in that place. And that was a really weird experience, because I felt like I was going to cry, because it was just so overly emotionally beautiful, and then just everything was amazing to look at. But I think that helps a lot of people. But then also there was a flip side of like, this is obsessional, you know, this is, people are obsessed in here.
Yeah.
And that's a weird thing for people to be obsessed about. It's a weird thing for a human emotion to be obsessed about something. It's something that's not tangible.
Yeah, and I think that's the one thing I've got, I always had a struggle with the concept of God, is because, as we discussed, it's like it's so unfathomably uncomprehendable.
Yeah.
That there's no tangibility to it.
Yeah.
And from someone like myself, who's very hard based in science and fact.
Yeah.
And yes and no and black and white, I found it very difficult.
Yeah.
And it always confused me when I was taught by teachers for science who were also devout Christians. Like in secondary school, we had a couple of, in university, I went did a sports science course. And even though it's only sports science, it's still science itself. Yeah. And there was a couple of lecturers there who were Christians as well, teaching science. And I always found that strange.
That is strange, yeah.
But yeah, I think organized religion is not the way to go. I remember, funny little story, is like when I was young and was going to church as part of the school trips, my brother was in the stage of dyeing his hair, being the rebellious type, and my mum was all for it. So she would dye his hair for him, and he had it dyed blonde, and then he had, I think it was red, or it was meant to be red, or it was meant to be purple. I can never remember which way it was. And he put it in his hair, and it turned out the wrong colour. So when I was younger, I had like a quiff at the front of my head, and it used to stand up like a pineapple.
Yeah.
Like all the time. So I was known for my swirly head. And my mum bleached that bit for me, and then dyed it the colour, and it turned out like bright purple or something. And then the next day I had to go to church, but nobody ever mentioned it, apart from the teacher walking home. It's like, have you dyed your hair? No, I haven't. It was my mum.
Yeah.
I can understand why you make the incorrect assumption.
Yeah.
I was very articulate as a child.
But what?
I wasn't.
That's a nice story. What's that got to do with it?
It's just a funny story.
Okay.
Yeah. Nothing to do with God. What would you say is the worst aspect about God?
God.
Capital G.
I'm not sure. I think the worst thing about God is that Just give me a moment to think about what do you think your worst is?
My worst thing about God is the concept of hell.
Yeah.
Hell is eternal anguish.
Yeah.
Like, just constant pain. And if you break a rule of his, he'll send you there forever.
Yeah, I think that is kind of mental. I was thinking that more like there are rules in place, and if you break them, you're just damned. And that's a weird thing.
Yeah.
There's no redemption, really. And they say there is redemption, but there isn't really redemption.
No, once you're in hell, that's pretty much it.
Yeah.
Before you get to hell, yeah, there's redemption. You can just say you're sorry.
Yeah.
Repent for those sins of yours, but if it's too late, it's too late. And then I just don't get that whole idea of...
I think the worst thing and the best thing about God, they both are equal. I think that there is a obsessional love that can be the worst and the best thing.
For him?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The worst thing being that people do things in the name of him, saying that it's right, like crimes and, you know, the whole crusades and stuff like that. And they
justified murder.
Justified murder. They do things in the name saying it's right and they would like it. And it's not, but that's what they believe.
Yeah.
And the best thing is people really do believe in it, and they do kind of get saved in a way. You always hear about people who find God later in life, you know, and after being like quite hedonistic, and they have quite a mental life, or they might be in prison or whatever, and they always say, oh, I found God, and you know, cleaned my act up. That's really good, because that's something that they can also. But I think that might be because they're channeling their efforts in something. But these people, it's a bit like how in Trainspotting 2. They said, like,
right.
Yeah, just people said, he was saying that, what's the main character called? Ewan McGregor's character.
Me and who?
Ewan McGregor, Renton.
Me and McGregor.
Ewan McGregor. Shut up. Renton was saying how, like, Spud was asking him, how do you get over heroin? He's like, I found something else to be addicted to. And his addiction was like running and getting away. That was his addiction, was getting away from, you know, Edinburgh and things like that. And
yeah,
I think that's what people do. I think that's what people do now for addictions and stuff. When they say I found God, is they become addicted to having that as their guide, like their drive, making God happy instead of drinking or alcohol. And that's really good. But then the other flips.
I don't agree with that, because like, say for example, the AA, you know, the 12-step program.
Sticky the car people. Yeah.
The 12-step. Like Alcoholics Anonymous program.
Yeah.
Step one, or one of the steps anyway, is to
admit you're an alcoholic.
Oh yeah, that's probably step one. But one of the steps is to believe in God.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, you have to believe in God, because then most alcoholics consider themselves like very high powered individuals. And if you release yourself to the power of God, then you step up in the program.
Yeah.
But you can only complete AA if you believe in God. So if someone fails to complete the course of AA, it could just be because they're atheist or something.
So there's never been any evidence of a God.
No.
No. And yet people still do bad things in the name of it.
Yeah.
But also what I find weird is that I was like thinking about this recently, the Bible, where everything came, and you know, it literally was a book written by people.
Yeah.
Like it wasn't written by God. No, it didn't come out of anywhere, and it didn't like appear. Like, it wasn't discovered in a cave. It was written by actual people as a story. So,
and a lot of it was heavily edited.
Yeah.
Because it's like the King James version.
Yeah, but Christians think they're the only religion. No, you're probably one of the newest religions out there.
Yeah, I'd say.
Yeah.
Probably. Well,
I don't like Christianity.
I figured. Yeah. Okay, how about this then? Because I know for a fact you and I have got wildly different opinions about this next thing.
Okay.
You comfy?
I'm folding myself. Yeah.
You're folding yourself.
Yeah.
The Queen.
Yeah. Why is this under God?
I, living in England, we have a queen, obviously, as you probably know. She's quite famous. And she is given the right to rule by the grace of God.
Yeah.
Back in, like, whenever the first king or queen was. I don't know my history that well. Yeah, I'd assume that probably 98% of the population or somewhere thereabouts believed in God.
Mm-hmm.
Because it was dark times.
This is before the dark times. Athelstan was the first English king.
Who was?
Athelstan.
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 When was this?
Like, I don't know, the 1100s, something like that.
Okay, so in the 1100s or so, somewhere around there, you had Athelstan as the first king.
Carry on.
And he was given right to rule mm-hmm. by the grace of God. Now, this is 21st century in which most people, I assume, if there was like a legitimate consensus.
Oh, well, that was no, that's it. The year 924 to 927.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. So even before the...
So 1,000 years ago.
Yeah, 1,000 years ago. Yeah.
1,000 years ago, there was a bloke who was God and he was given right to rule over the dominion of England
mm-hmm.
by the grace of God.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if there was a genuine 100% correct consensus, or census rather, about people's opinion on God and whether or not they're atheist or agnostic or Christian or they believe in God, I would assume most people would say that they don't believe in God.
Mm-hmm.
Now, does she still have the right to rule because God granted her the right to rule even though most people don't believe in God, if that statistic were true?
Yeah,
which it might be.
I think that
because you love royal family.
I do love the royal family, but because they do so much for the country.
Do they?
They do. They bring in millions and billions of pounds of tourism every year.
And how much was the wedding?
I don't know, maybe 100 million? But then that brought in tourism. That's brought in tourism from that. Because we're one of the countries in the EU, well, apart from like, you know, but France doesn't have a king and queen anymore, Italy doesn't have a king and queen anymore. A lot of places don't have kings and queens, so people from America and other countries who don't have royalty and princesses who live in castles, they come over because they never had anything like that.
I suppose.
The amount of money they do bring in, and popularity they bring in.
Still grinds my gears.
I know it grinds your gears, but you can't dispute facts. They do a lot for the country.
Fine.
Yeah.
On that happy note.
I think the right to rule as like an autocrat, which was kind of the whole right to rule by the thought of God, that is an outdated system now, yes. But the Queen and the Windsors and things, they have had, you know, there's like people who have this job sort of handed down to them. They know what they're doing.
Yeah,
be taught from a young age, they know what to do. It's not like he threw like you into it and you like, right, rule the country and do these things and know how to speak and know how to run a commonwealth and talk to dignitaries around the world and keep you cool. Because I don't think I could do that. But she's had that job put on her since she was a child.
Yeah.
And she can do it. She does it very well. And I think that's what keeps her there. It's the people's popularity. But I think the whole idea that she was picked down by God, that is an outdated system from like the 1500s and stuff.
Yeah.
Because that's when Henry VIII, with that sort of time, when he had made the Protestant church.
Mm.
I think that was the last big time you had God and religion pushed together.
Yeah.
Religion and the monarchy pushed together. Whereas now it's like, nah, it's not as important.
Yeah, I understand that.
Yeah.
Do you have any final words before we leave about God?
No. What about you?
No, actually. I think we've made our point clear.
Yeah.
We'd like to know what you guys think in the comment section below.
Yeah, like, once again, like I said like last time with the Just by Killing, I'd like to hear other people say about their religions, because I don't know much about other religions at all. And I'm the first person to say I throw my hands up, like, I don't know much. I'm not going to try and say, well, in Judaism, they believe this, and I might say it wrong.
Yeah, that's why I've not listed it. I know Christianity quite well.
I don't know even Christianity that quite well, but I know the basics, I think.
Weird.
Yeah.
Considering your background, I mean.
Yeah, but my mum's for this lax Catholic you ever meet in your life.
True.
So.
Yeah. So let us know what you guys think about God. Definitely. And and whether or not you agree with anything that we said or disagreed. Mm-hmm. And if you're a Patreon supporter, I'd like to say a big thank you. If you're a Patreon supporter, as I said at the beginning of the show, you are able to get access to this podcast-y type thing the next day in audio download on Patreon. So if you want to be a part of the Gizzards, all you need to do is donate $1 to patreon.com/GizEdwards. You get access to this and the podcast.
What's our next week's topic?
I don't know what our next week's topic. Should we have a look what we've got?
So we can, like, people can come back.
Time travel? We could do time travel, meaning of life. If you're on Patreon and you're listening to this, then let us know what you guys want to hear next week. How about that?
And if it's not in our list, we could definitely put up there.
Yeah, boy.
Yeah.
So until then, my video's just stopped recorded.
I haven't. Ha ha ha.
Do the outro.
I don't have the outro.
Until then, do that.
Until then, bye.
Maybe at the camera.
Until then, bye.
That was pathetic, but all right. See you later, guys.
Love you.